In part one, we set up a build environment and installed our drivers. Next, we'll set up a system to make sure that you have the latest version of QMK firmware, have a place to keep a personal backup of your files online, and can contribute to QMK. I should have rolled this into part one, but I was worried about making things too complicated. Unfortunately, we're going to have to backtrack just a little, so let's get on with it. If you've made any changes inside the QMK firmware folder, such as editing a keymap, you must make a backup of those files. We're going to delete the QMK firmware folder and clone in a new one using Git on the command line. So copy any files that you want to keep and put them somewhere safe. Now delete the QMK firmware folder entirely. Don't worry, we'll put it back in a minute. If you haven't already, make an account on GitHub. Once you've done that, search for the QMK project and fork QMK. This will be your own copy of QMK that you can add your keymaps and other changes to. Click the button that says fork. Now go to the QMK page for your QMK firmware fork. We're not going to download it this time. Using Git from the start makes things easier in the long run. Since you're used to the command line now, it shouldn't be too much trouble. Copy the URL that you see when you click the green button. Now open a terminal and go to the directory you want the new folder to appear. I'll just put mine in the same folder as last time, so for me that's cd/k/keyboards. Now type git clone and then paste in the URL for your copy of the QMK firmware. Hit enter and the fork will be copied to your machine along with all the relevant info about where it lives on GitHub and files needed for Git to track the changes. Now, go to that directory using the cd command. Now we add what we call the upstream repository. When we refer to upstream, we mean the official QMK firmware repository. When we refer to origin, we mean our copy that is stored remotely on GitHub, that's our fork. Your local master is the one that lives on your PC. This command means that we want to add a remote repository, track the master branch, and that when we say upstream, we mean the master branch. Let's check if there have been changes to upstream. Git fetch upstream. If there are any changes, they'll appear here. We then merge these changes into our local master and we're bang up to date. Git merge upstream. You likely won't have any updates if you just forked and cloned in the last 2 minutes. Here, I've been bumped into a wonderful text editor called Vim that makes very little sense to mere mortals like myself. I have to leave a message describing why this merge happened. In this case, it's already filled in at the top there in yellow. All we need to do is type a colon, then W and Q. That'll write the file with our message and quit Vim forever. Those last two commands, fetch and merge, are the ones you'll run to check for updates to the official QMK repository and merge them with what you have on your PC. If you moved any files to a safe place, then paste them back to where they were before. You're almost ready to start editing keymaps, and that'll be in part 3.